Welcome to Java Forum. Now we are going to see how to install and configure Visual Studio Code 1.41, that is December 2019 release on Oracle Linux 8 operating system. So here you can see that I already downloaded a Visual Studio Code tar.gz file for Linux operating system. So I'm going to extract this tar.gz file to /opt directory. Make sure that you have enough permission to extract the content to /opt directory. So this tar.gz file is a generic file which can be used in multiple flavors of Linux. So extraction completed, I am renaming the extracted directory. And this is the directory structure of Visual Studio Code 1.41. which contains bin directory and it supports multiple locales. I'm opening the terminal now. So first thing is I am giving permission to Visual Studio Code directory so that other users also can execute that command. So now I'm going to bin directory of Visual Studio Code and going to start the Visual Studio Code. /code is the command, but unfortunately Visual Studio Code is asking for dependent library. So this is the dependent library name, libx screensaver. So I already downloaded from the internet, and also this RPM is available in the Oracle Linux 8 DVD also. You can get from there also. So let me install that dependency, libx screensaver RPM. So this is a dependency by required by Visual Studio Code. So I installed the dependency successfully. Let me start the Visual Studio Code once again. /code is the command. Yes, you can see that Visual Studio Code had been started. So this is a welcome page. Let me navigate the menus. So Visual Studio Code is a lightweight IDE, supports multiple programming languages. So let me open new terminal in the Visual Studio Code and split the terminal into multiple terminal. So now I am going to demonstrate how to execute Linux commands on multiple terminals in Visual Studio Code. So you can also learn Linux using Visual Studio Code. Yes, so rendering is also good. So the graphical tool performance purely depends upon the desktop manager on your Linux operating system. So I am closing now. Now what I am going to do is I am going to add the Visual Studio Code executable files to bash profile. So I'm opening the bash profile. So I'm going to add the bin directory, Visual Studio Code bin directory, to the bash profile so that Visual Studio Code 1.41 will be available during the startup. So no need to execute as /code. Instead, you can simply type code. So save the bash profile. So now once again, opening the terminal in current directory. I'm going to type the command source.bash_profile, which will loads the latest changes in the bash profile settings. So I am typing code. So this will start the Visual Studio Code. So Visual Studio Code 1.4 installation on Oracle Linux 8 is successful. So Visual Studio Code is a very, very useful tool for programmers, developers,